Now, it threatened to take some Edmonton broadcasting students to court if they didn't change the name of their college news show. Reid Feist has a story.
We do three segments.
It's the end of an era at NAIT. For over a decade, the school's broadcasting program has produced a news show called NTV.
Let me know if it's level.
But now, NAIT News has been forced to sign off.
The award-winning NTV Evening News Hour.
All because Newfoundland's NTV sent a cease and desist order to NAIT to take its NTV off the air.
It just seemed like a natural name. You know, we're here at NAIT and we produce TV, so NTV seemed like a natural fit.
To students, the order seemed heavy-handed, considering only 3 weeks remain in the semester, and their show only airs once a week on Access.
It bothered all of us at first because we're a college, you know, at least let us go through the semester, maybe, before changing everything, but, I guess we're a threat now.
The opener had to be recut, some of the different elements in the story, they all had to get redone. It was a little bit hard.
But to NTV, 3.5 time zones away, it's pretty simple. They own the rights to the name.
The time, effort, and money our company has invested in the NTV News brand, which is now one of the leading newscasts in all of Canada, not just Newfoundland and Labrador, all of Canada, I'm sure they can respect wanting to protect the integrity of our brand.
The St. John station ran into name problems of its own back in the 70s. Newfoundland Broadcasting Corporation, or NBC as they branded themselves, got a call from their namesake south of the border.
Obviously, there's an NBC in the States who requested us to change our name, which we did. We respected that and changed it.
Now the students at NAIT look at the name battle as a good life lesson and some good PR.
In some ways, it's nice to be known that way over across the country in Newfoundland that they've heard of us. So that's a positive sign, I guess you can look at it like that.
Reid Feist, Global News.
NAIT News airs Sunday at 5 on Access.